in this case, is the time in seconds. Probably time to get down, because this says elevation, so it's up or down. So time to get going down. Independent. Is time in seconds. Let's say so right here. In seconds. To go down. Or just, well, let's just times in seconds. And elevation and dependent is the elevation in meters. Make sure I'm spelling it right. Sorry. And dependent is elevation in meters. In this case, I should put time in seconds going down. Down to meters. Anyways, x-intercept. What is the x-intercept? X-intercept, intercept. The word intercept is cross. The x-axis. When will it cross the x-axis? So I want to see this annotation. X-intercept, cross the x-axis. When will the line cross the x-axis? Okay, if you drew this line continuously, graph B here. If you can draw the line continuously, it means goes on forever. Uh-oh, sorry. It intersects the x-axis at this number right here, 4, 0. Okay? And the x-intercept then, x-intercept, is at 4, 0. Meaning that it takes 4 seconds, as 4 is in second, to get to 0 feet, to get to ground floor. Meaning it will take 4 seconds to get to ground level. 0 is ground level. Okay? What is the rate of change in unit rate? Well, rate of change, unit rate. Rate of change is the same thing as slope. Unit rate is finding 1. We need to annotate. M stands for slope. Okay, unit rate. I'm going to look for annotation. Unit rate, find how much in 1 second? How many feet in 1 second? That's one unit rate. Okay, let's look. I'm going to take 4, 0, and 80 here. I'm going to take those two numbers. 80, 0, 80. So to find the unit rate of change, m equals to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay? M equals y2 is 0 right here, and 0, y1 is 80, so So y2 is 0 minus 80 y1 over x2, which is 4 right there, minus 0 up here. So you got negative 80 over 4. That's my rate of change, and my rate of change, my slope can be reduced to negative 20 over 1, which is also the unit rate. Okay, the rate of change, this happens to be a unit rate. This is 1 second now. It's going down 20 feet for 1 second, for every 1 second. Okay, remember that? Okay, so in this case, the rate of change would be negative 80 over 4, and the unit rate would be negative 20 over 1. The rate of change is basically negative 20 over 1 reduced, which is the same as the unit rate. Okay? That means you go down 20 feet every 1 second. Because I can ask that, what your rate means, and you need to know what it means. Write an equation of a line in point slope form. Okay, remember, I want you to annotate. Point slope form is y minus y1 equals times x minus x1. And in slope intercept form, which is y equals to mx plus b. So they want to write an equation in both. Okay, so I'll pick 0, 4. It's easy. 4, 0, I mean. That's my point. My slope I got, which is from here. I don't have to work for my slope, which is the same as my rate of change. Negative 20. So my slope is negative 20. The point I want to use is 4, 0. So y, not y1, it's just y. So we got y here minus 0 equals to m negative 20 parentheses x minus 4. So we got distribute. Y minus 0 equals to negative 20 plus 80. Don't forget the x there. And then that's y equals 0 minus y is 0, negative 20 x plus 80. I don't know why I didn't solve it here, but okay. Okay, write a sentence about the independent and dependent variable. Okay, independent is your x, annotate. Dependent is your y. Right there is your y. The y is dependent. Okay? So, sentence. The independent is numbers of servings. The number of servings. made, and the dependent variable is milk remaining. How much milk is left? X-intercept. X-intercept and what it means. Okay, right here, x-intercept, I'm assuming it's perfectly here at 10, 0. X-intercept means, okay, where will the graph cross the x-axis? I need you to annotate these. You guys need to know the meaning of these things. You read the question, you don't know what it means, you can't answer it. So the x-intercept is where it crosses the x-axis. Here's the x-axis. It will cross, if this line continues continuously, it will cross the x-axis right here at 10, 0. What does that mean? X-intercept is 10, 0, meaning after 10 servings, there will be no milk left, because milk remaining, see how much milk remaining? Zero. There will be zero milk remaining. That means there's no milk left. After 10 people have been served, there'll be no milk left. The rate of change. Okay, the rate of change or the unit rate, all right? The rate of change is, remember, it's slope m equals to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Rate of change is slope. Unit rate, need to annotate what one serving. This is one serving. One serving of milk, how much milk do they get? Unit rate is always one of something out of it all. Okay, let's find slope. Well, this is right here is 15, 0, 0, 0, 0, 15. Okay, so here's your y2, Y2 and Y1. X2 and X1. Okay. Y2 is 0 minus 15. All over X2, which is 10, minus 0. Negative 15 over 10, or the rate of change is the rate of change is reduce this to negative 3 over 2 is negative 3 over 2. And the unit rate is okay, unit rate is what one is, okay? So we in order to find what one is, we have to divide these. Okay, calculator. Where's my calculator? It won't show up. Show back here? Okay. 3 divided by 2 is 1.5. Okay? So unit rate is 1.5 over 1. That means after 1.5 serving, with one serving, every serving, one serving, we give people 1.5 cup of milk, right? Is this cups? Yep. 1.5 cups of milk for every serving. So that in 10 servings, all the milks are gone. 1.5 cup of milk for every serving. Three cups for two servings, therefore 1.5 for 1.5 cups for every serving. Okay? Put a negative if you want, but it just tells you the graph is going down. But when you talk about serving stuff, write an equation or line in point slope, annotate. Point slope, y minus y1 equals to m parentheses x minus x1. Slope intercept, oh, vocabulary word slope intercept. Y equals to mx plus b. Okay, write an equation one first. In point slope, the other one in slope intercept. Okay, so I'm going to use, I need a slope. You always use a rate of change and never unit rate. So my slope is negative 3 over 2. The point I'm going to use is 10, 0. Using our formula here, y minus y1, the point slope formula equals m parentheses x minus x1, substitute it in, y minus 0 equals to m parentheses 0 minus 0. Oh, that's not 0, 0. What am I doing? It's 10. No. Yeah, it's 10. Sorry. And this is not 0. This is x. So, and what do we put for slope? Substitute slope in for negative 3 over 2. Sorry, guys. Went to sleep there for a second. Okay, substitute your numbers in, and you got that. We got negative 3 over 2x. Distribute. Now 3 over 2 times 10. Cross cancel. That's 5. That's a positive because a negative and a negative, remember, it's a positive. 15. Okay, second page. Alexis in the past paid $19 to park in the downtown parking garage for a 3-hour event. Today, after spending 5 hours downtown, she paid $25. Write a linear equation in point slope form. Slope intercept. Slope intercept y equals to mx plus b. Okay? So first she has 3 and 19 and 5 and 25. Okay? So now it's x1, y1, x2, y2. Okay? First, find slope. Point slope. We're going to need, no matter what, we can't solve this without point slope. Slope equals 2. Y2 minus y1, this minus this, over x2 minus x1. see. M equals 25 minus 19 over 5 minus 3. That gives you 6 over 2. M equals to 6 over 2 or just 3. So M equals to 3. Okay, so I'm going to pick 5 and 25. It's just like easier than 3 and 19. Even though it's bigger, 5 and 25 is easier. So I'm going to pick 5 and 25. For those of you who picked 9 and 19, you should come up with the same answer as I do. Okay, using this slope right here, we just solve for, and this line we choose from these two problems, we choose one. Okay, so we have, remember our, so, well, to get to this, we need to do y minus y1 equals to point slope, x minus x1. This is called point slope, point and a slope. Y minus y1, which is 25, equals to 3 parentheses for slope right there. X minus 5. Okay, so we distribute, that's 3x minus 15 equals to y minus 25. Add 25. Add 25, y equals to 3x plus 10. Hey, slope-intercept form, that's what we need to graph, correct? Okay, I'm going to graph this up to 25, from 3 to 25. I'm going to move by 5 if you want for the y. And what does the y mean? Y is cost for parking, right? This is $25 for parking, $19 paid for parking. Okay, cost for parking. It's the cost for parking. And the x-intercept is hours, because it says 3 hours here. It's hours, time in hours. And those are by ones, twos, threes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, so forth. I don't think I need that many. But anyways, oh, we can do what the book does. Oh, we'll just leave it as 1. It's easier for you guys. Okay. 19 and 25, they're odd numbers, but we got a lot of space. We can incorporate them by counting by 2s. Okay, we can go by 2s here. Put this up 3 over 1. I can count by, can I count by 1s? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. No, not really. Well, I don't need to put number 5 in there, do I? You don't have to. You can do by 2s. I'm going to do by 2s. So, I'm going to do by 2s. I'll show you how that can happen with 2s. Doing by 5, you'll get a tiny graph, and it won't look good. So I'm going to do by 2s. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Oh, it's 4, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Twenty-two, the y-intercept is at 10, so it's right there, and your slope is 3 over 1, up 3 to the right 1, okay, so from 10, 11, 12, 13, 13's right there to the right 1. To the right. Up 3 and right 1. Did I go up 1, 2, 3? Oops, sorry. And the right 1. And there I go. Up 3, 1, 2, 3, right 1. 1, no, that's not 1, that's halfway. 1, 2, 3, right 1. Okay, all my little dots out of the way. And then you can do it by 1s, probably easiest. You just wouldn't include. Notice that 3 and 19, 3 and 19 is part of, made a mistake. Where's my mistake? Right down here. Oh no, I made a major mistake. I count 3 instead of thinking by 2. See, notice this. Look how I check myself. 3 and 19 is supposed to be in there. 3 and 19. A lot of you did this wrong on the test. 3 and 19. I went 3 and 19. Oh no, it's not there. What did I do wrong? 5 and 25. Oh no, it's not 5 and 25. Oh no, I did something wrong. Went back and look, and I literally count by ones. Instead, I know I forgot that I counted by 3 here. By 2s on the graph. So when I count, it's 1. 10 is right there. 11, 12, 13 over 1 is right there. So 1, 2, 3 over 1. I went too far. 1, 2, 3 over 1. 1, 1, 2, 3 over 1. 1, 2, 3 over 1. 1, 1, 2, 3 over 1. Okay, 1, 2, 3 over 1. Okay, that's long enough. 20. And we can keep going. Okay, now let's check. 3 and 19 needs to be in there. 3 and 19. Oh, yep. That's 18, 19, and then 20. Okay, and then 5 and 25. 5 and 24, 25 is right there, perfect. So the 2, 5, and 25 needs to be here. And the 3 and 19 needs to be there. Okay. Determine the y-intercept. Okay, determine the y-intercept. What is the y-intercept? Y-intercept where it cross the y-axis. Where is the point on the y-axis? Right there. 9 means 0, 10.
whole line.
If you continue forever going in both directions, where would it cross the y-axis? Right there. Crosses the y-axis. Intersect means crosses. Okay? So 0, 10 means before they start, 0 minutes before they start, they were already, it already cost them $10. Before, as soon as you get into that parking lot, it costs you initial $10 to get into the parking lot. The y-intercept is 0. Y-intercept is 0:10. Jeez. They're loud out there watching their game, which is great. 0:10, that means cost them $10 to just enter with no time. Time doesn't matter. Cost $10 to get into the parking lot. Into the parking lot. So you have to pay $10 to get into the parking lot. And time has not started. Okay, that's what the y-intercept means. Serena received a gift card to the local movie theater. After two movies, the balance on her card dropped to $64. So she got a gift card. After going to five movies, her balance was $40. So after two movies, it was $64. After five movies, it was $40. Write the relation in slope-intercept form. Slope-intercept form, I'm going to look for annotation, is y equals to mx plus b. On your test too, you guys, I'm going to start watching you guys annotate what you know. All right, so we get m equals to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, y2 minus y1, that's x1, x2, y2, doesn't really matter. x1, y1, okay? That gives you 40 minus 64 over 5 minus 2, which is m equals to 24 negative over 3, which is m equals to negative 8 over 1. It's also the unit rate of change here. Slope is the rate of change and unit rate of change. All right. Y, we can't use the formula. We cannot substitute in here. We don't know what b is in order to to substitute in. So in order to solve this, you need to use point slope. Let's see the other. You got slope here, and we need a point. I'm going to use 5 and 40. No, 5, 40. Doesn't matter. Your answer should come out the same. So let's go y. You need to start with point slope equals parentheses mx minus x.
Kaylee Reyes. You deport July. We're more with you. Kaylee Ray.
Y minus x1, y1 here, 40, equals to negative 8 is slope times x minus 5. So here you have y minus 40 equals to negative 8x plus 40. Be careful here, it's negative and a negative. It's a positive. Okay? plus 40 plus 40. Y equals to negative 8x plus 80. Wow, this is big. Goes up to y-intercept is at 80, but notice it's going down. So your highest point just needs to be 80. So the y-intercept is at 0. Okay, y-intercept is at 0, 80. We're across the y-axis. What does that mean? Now, she received a gift card. The balance of the move to the local movie, after two movies, there are $64. Okay. So we can, so 080 then must be, there were $80 on that ticket before she bought the two movie tickets. Someone gave her, the gift card had $80 on it. That's what it means. You need to go back to find the y-intercept, what it means to the word problems, and not just say total of $80. Okay? You can't do that. So, the y is money on the gift card.
Brenda Ludon, please report to the library of mom's here. Brenda Ludon.
Of money on the gift card. Gift card amount. Gift card amount. Okay, it's gift card amount. And the independent variable is the number of movies. Okay, so number of movies is easy. It's 2 and 5 is the most that's on there. So you can do 1, 2 again, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, whichever way. Amount you guys may have trouble with. You have to have at least 80 on there. So there are, again, coming back to the interval of graphing, there are 1, 2, 3, 4. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 divided by the 80 that you need, the 80 initial dollars that's on the card divided by 20, telling you to count by 4. So let's count by 5. I'm going to make it easy for ourselves and count by 5s. Remember how we come up with the interval table? That's, it's coming important again. It's applying that all. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90, 95, 100. Okay? Anyways, I'm going to erase that. But you understand how I came up with counting by 5, because the 80 is the highest I can get. She received a gift card, and local, in after spending $64, then 40, so it's coming down. She started off with $80 on the gift card right here. $80 on the gift card. Okay, so that's your y-intercept. Meaning that Serena was given an $80 gift card. Was given a gift card worth $80. Pretty nice gift card. Okay, so here it is. Here's her gift card at $80. And from there, she minus $8 per ticket that she buys. Oh, So the slope is to go down 8 and over 1. It's kind of hard. Wow. Let's count by 4s. It'll be easier if we count by 4s. 5 is too hard. You notice, see, I did this and it counted wrong. So when your slope is 8 over 1, it's easier to count by 4s. 5 was not a good deal. It included everything, but I had to go back and count by 4s. 80, because... there's 20 of them, might as well count by 4s. What happened to my... uh-oh. I can't get it back. Ah, I keep deleting too much. Anyways. I'll have fun loading this up. Okay. Anyways, we've discovered we cannot use 5. We best choose 4. Because our rate of change is negative 8 over 1. That's our slope. So best to use 4. So if it's 4, 8 times 3 is 12, times 4 is 16, times 5 is 20, times 6 is 24, times 7 is 28, times 8 is 32, times 9 is 36, times 10 is 40, times 11 is 44, add 4 more is 48, add 4 more is 52, add 4 more is 56. Aha, notice this pattern right here. 6 after 6 is another 4. No, it's wrong. Let me check. Okay, 40, 44, 48, 52, 56 is right here, 56 is here, 56 is 60, okay, I'm right here then, 60, another one, you get 64, just to avoid mistakes, more mistakes, is just go ahead. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 30, 32. See? See? It's 28. Didn't make sense to me. 32, 36, 40, 44, 48, 52, 56, 60, 64, 68, 72, 76, 80, right there. Well, our starting point is at $80 on the gift card. Thank God. You go down 8 and over 1. Down 8, 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 over 1. Okay, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to start numbering these for you. Okay. So... now, what does your x-intercept mean? Right here. 10 movie tickets. And you get 10 movie tickets for $80. There's no money left. 10 movie tickets. We do not connect this line. Let me see. Do we connect the other line? Yep. Time and cost of... Yep. This one we do not connect because we can't have half of a movie ticket. 0.5. So we actually need to leave this like this. We do not connect it. Just can't buy half a movie ticket. Okay, that's our answer there. Wow, it took us a while, for me anyways, to graph that. On your own, it's probably impossible. I will start numbering them for you to make your test go faster. I didn't realize this was on. Just concentrating on my iPad. Oh, thank God, something easy. No. Well, anyways. Here we go. Calculate the y-intercept. Okay, y-intercept. Where your line crossed the y-axis. X-intercept. Where it crossed the x-axis. Okay, for each linear equation in standard form. Sketch graph. All right. Let's do y-intercept. Y-intercept, because we like that. Y-intercept, cross out the x, pretend it's not there, because it's zero. It's zero anyways, because x is zero. Okay, notice on all our y-intercept, that's 0, 80, x is zero. Okay, that's y. Notice x-intercept, x is zero, y is, okay. If you want to see all of them, x is zero, y is something. X is 0, okay? So, prove it. Y-intercept, X is 0, okay? 0 times 4 is 0, so it, like it doesn't exist. So we cover it up, and we only have negative 7y equals to negative 56. Divided by negative 7, divided by negative 7. Don't mark like this on yours, because you still need to see yours, okay? Mine is just, I use my finger in class to cover it. That's a positive 8. So your y-intercept is 0, 8, which is here. Okay, your x-intercept, where it crosses the x-axis. Sorry, spelled intercept wrong. You cover your y, go back to the problem, pretend it's 0 because... y is 0 right here, so 7 times negative 7 times 0 is 0, so that's why we just cover it up, pretend it's not there, and we only have the problem of 4x equals to negative 56, divide by 4, divide by 4, that's 16, negative, right? X equals to negative 14, yes, negative 14. So your answer is negative 14, 0, because negative 14, 0 is right here. And then, see, we draw a line through it, proving that it crosses, that it goes through the x-axis right here at this point. If we didn't have the dots, okay, we draw the lines only. It passes through the x-axis here and the y-axis there. That's why it's called the x and y-intercept. It crosses those points. Oh, I hope you guys understand this. Y-intercept. You know what a y-intercept is. Okay. Take this out. Take out the x because it's x is 0. 6y equals to 54, divide by 6, divide by 6, y equals to 9, or 0, 9, which is, here's 8, there's 10, 9 is right smack in the middle. Okay, crosses somewhere there. It's my estimation. of 9. Now the x-intercept. Okay, we pretend, erase that. This, oops, don't like that color. The y is not there because it equals to 0. 6 times 0 is 0. So you got 3x equals to 54. Divide by 3, divide by 3. X equals to 18. Yep, 18 times 3 is 54. So it's 18 and 0. 18 and 0, here's 16, here's 18 and 0. So we draw a line passing through the x and y intercept. And if we get rid of, oops, we get rid of the dots, we will notice that the lines do cross. This linear line do cross at 9, x, y at 9, and x at 18. That's why it's called the x and y intercept, okay? All right. Y intercept. Okay, we cross out the x because x is 0. You got negative 2y equals to 40. Divide by negative 2, divide by negative 2. Y equals to negative 20. Okay? Y equals to negative 20. Y negative 20 is 18. Oh, no, no. Y negative 20 is way down here. Oh, wrong one. Y negative 20 is down here. It's negative 18, negative 20, right there. Okay? And then x, x-intercept. I don't like this color. Sorry, guys. Intercept. Okay. We pretend y is not there because it's 0. 2 times 0 is 0. And we got that. Negative 2 times 0 is still 0. Get negative 4x equals to 40. Divide by negative 4. Divide by negative 4. X equals to negative 10. Okay. X is negative 10. That's negative 10, 0, which is right here, okay, right there, the two lines, connect, and draw a line that passes, oh, that didn't pass through, quite passed through. Notice that if you, oops, get rid, anyways, it passes. All right, last one, or not last one, anyways, let's do this one here. 8x, let's do y-intercept. The zeros here makes it eliminated, gone for y. Okay. We can find x-intercept negative 4, y equals to 64, divide by negative 4, divide by negative 4, y equals to negative 1, negative 16. Yeah, that's negative. Okay, y is negative 16, which is right there. That's 0, negative 16. Okay, x-intercept. Is, get rid of the, pretend y is not there. Because it's negative 4 times 0. Negative 4 times 0 is 0. It's not there. So you got 8x equals to 64. Divide by 8. Divide by 8. X-intercept is at 8. Or 8, 0. Right there. Draw a line going through those two points. Because that's what intercept means. The line goes across the intercept. Line it go across this x-axis right here is at this point right there. Okay. And line that goes through the y-axis is at this point right here. Okay. Solve the following equations. Alrighty. Least common denominator, 4. Multiply all of them by 4. Okay, cross cancel, 4, 4. Well, that's 1, 1. That leaves negative 2, parentheses m plus 3. That's easy. Cross cancel, 1 and 2. That leaves 10, because 5 times the 2 is 10. Equals. Cross cancel, 4 and 4 is 1, 1. So that leaves you 3x. Woo! Makes it easy. Okay, that's negative 2m. Negative 6 plus 10 equals 3x. Combine these because they're alike. You get a 4 there. Negative 2m plus the positive 4 equals the 3x. Need to get rid of this x, m. Did I put, oh my gosh, I meant to write m here again. Not x, guys, so sorry. M, and I didn't realize it till the very end. Add 2m. Okay, got 4 equals to 5m. Divide by 5. Divide by 5, because 4 cannot be divided by 5. The answer is just simple 4 over 5. Okay, that's how you do that. Oh my gosh.